So, good evening, people. Namaste. I am Daksh. I am the founder of Love World Magazine, which works on the focus of teens inspiring teens. We try to find teenagers who are doing great in life and showcase their struggles and stories with other teenagers so that a lot of good work happens within teenagers. So this today is the 32nd edition of the Love World Web Talks. We have done 31 before these, and more than 300 school leaders from across 60 geographies from around the world have participated till now. And they had shared their ideas on a white paper that we are bringing out on the 15th of this month. The first white paper is on the topic of no lockdown on learning, which is supposed to give a repository of ideas on solutions that schools used or were using during the lockdown and which are scalable in the coming times within the schools. And today we are all here to talk on the topic, the post-lockdown school. Now, the reason why we have chosen this topic is every section of the society is supposed to contribute to the society in its own way, with its own capabilities and its ideas and its, whatever you can imagine, your imagination or your forecasting or your predicting skills. Your farmers are taking care of your food, police is taking care of security, doctors are taking care of your health. So what are educationists supposed to do? Educationists are supposed to deliver education, that's for sure. But yes, there's one more responsibility that falls onto you. Is to create the next knowledge bank that the world would need. And what we can see right now, that education, the way it was imparted till now, would drastically change in the post-lockdown world. So when a change comes in, there is a lot of innovation that's required, a lot of ideas that are required. So this particular activity is just to find out those small little big changes or innovations that a school can do in functioning in a better way in the post-corona world. Or a post-lockdown world rather, not a post-corona world, because we're not sure when this comes to an end or it stays with the race. So before I take your ideas, I'll just explain the format of this whole thing. All the speakers here get to speak for 2 minutes. Then you can see Divya Purohit on your screen. He's the timekeeper. So once your 2 minutes are finished, he'll put his one hand up. And then you have 30 more seconds to conclude. And once your 2 minutes and 30 seconds are over, he puts his second hand up. And that's the time that we might have to mute you. So please don't get offended if you get muted. It's only supposedly to be done so that nobody's schedule gets disturbed and we are able to finish this on time. And I hope you enjoy the next 30, 40 minutes listening to what all innovations can be done in the new school or the new classroom that we'll all see post this lockdown. Because we won't be having the same student with the same psyche that was there before this lockdown. We don't have the same teacher coming again to school. Their persona or their characteristics have already changed. They have come to a new world which has a mix of technology, a lot of screen time, a lot of parents, a lot of focus, and a lot of one-on-one teaching. How would it go back to one-to-many, and what all ideas do we need? So we have a special guest for today. Every day we have one special guest who adds a different perspective or typically a talka to the whole discussion. So we try to get that person to be other than somebody from the K-12 sector. And he's supposed to give us that right stimulus or typically ignite our brains to give us some more innovative thought coming in from you. So we have already shared his profile with you. We have with us Mr. Sahil Agarwal, the founder of Rishi Hood University. So Sahilji, over to you for the next 3 minutes. Give us something that excites everybody on the post-lockdown school. Over to Sahil, you can unmute your audio.
Thank you, Dakshi. You're already excited us. And you know, I'm here more as a listener because I can see luminaries from school education. So I'm myself very passionate about education, and it's always great to listen to the ideas that the educator and leaders in education bring to us. So when you shared this topic of the post-lockdown school, and I started thinking about it, and it came to my mind what we call the post-lockdown school should actually have been the pre-lockdown school. I mean, there were things that had been going fundamentally wrong, not just in school system, in education generally, but here we are focusing more on the school. So we should identify some of these things. And what COVID has done is that COVID has brought it in front of us. It has shown us that these were the things that were not going right. And you take this as an opportunity to reform the system. And I think it's a blessing in disguise that has come to us, not just for school, but also for higher education, for online learning, for any kind of learning. COVID has created new opportunities. So one is the distinction that our system had done between living and learning. I mean, we started thinking of these as two separate buckets. We are in school and we are doing something formal. We are in the classroom. We are reading our books. We are listening to our teacher. All this constitutes learning. We are at home. We are eating. We are talking to our friends. We are talking to our parents. We are meeting our grandparents. All that is living. And there was this distinction. And this distinction started creating stress and evaporated the joy from learning. So what we have to do is, in fact, merge these two. So living and learning can never be separated. They have to go hand in hand, and only then it will become so natural to us. So I think this is one of the major learnings. And how this has happened is now we know that everyone's learning style is different. Everyone's learning preferences are different. When they want to learn, how they want to learn, from whom they want to learn, what they want to learn. There's so many choices here. And our formal education system does not answer those choices, that kind of a personalized learning experience. So now, since all of us are adopting a digital mode, we have noticed that. And we are also able to overcome that. And it's so inspiring how our schools, you know, our teachers and principals are working and day in and day out to provide that kind of a learning to our students. So this is one big change. The other was the way we do examinations. So Abhi, you know, it's like an industrial era examination that we have created a product and we do a quality check at the end and we, you know, okay, tested kind of a thing. So I was saying that examinations have become a very industrial process. You know? So towards the end of the grade, we want to promote something and we say, okay, tested. And you know, we promote that person. But it has to become a very fluid and very, you know, a continuous process. CBSE and other boards are also trying to do that now. But that requires a fundamental mind shift in our teachers. Because jis tarah se everyone check karte hain, we are not able to actually judge. Everyone's ability to perform is different. Someone is able to write better, someone is able to speak better, someone is able to do a project better. So the way in which we conduct exams also motivates the student to perform. We have to create that kind of a comfort. Jaise hum life mein, you know, when we have to promote someone in our company, do a promotion or an appraisal, we do not conduct an exam. You know, we judge them based on whatever they have done so far and what their potential is. In our personal life, if a husband and wife do not go well together, we don't take a divorce based on an exam. There is a history to it and you know, there is a process to it. So we have to be open to the idea ki jo jis tarah se hum abhi apne students ko check kar rahe hain, that may not be the best way. Some more things have come up. Hum apne education system mein, we've largely restricted ourselves to our own team of teachers and principals and school leaders. But in Corona, I was so happy that all the schools are inviting external speakers to interact with their students virtually, interact with their teachers virtually. I think that's a great thing because our students need too much exposure. I'll stop at that.
Thank you, Sahil sir. I think you contributed a lot of small snippets to the whole discussion that can be actually elaborated on. Living and learning to be merged actually, to sustain and keep and continue the joy of learning, personalized learning, exams not as an industrial process but based on even customizing the examinations and historical analysis, and one very nice idea of external experts coming to a school. One of the schools I remember in somewhere in Uttar Pradesh is doing something very interesting. They've started creating an account out of their parents. They've asked their parents that what all you do in your life. Didn't have good internet, so they gave a very innovative assignment to their students. They told them to create a custom dictionary in which they have to add 5 new words every day. And once the school reopens, they bring back that dictionary. One school has told its students to do a daily news report on their surroundings, that what's all going on around you, give us a report on that. So we are posting ideas that we've got till now every day on the different platforms that we are there. You can find those ideas and even experiment within your ecosystems and tell us what happens. There's one school in Gujarat, which is a Swami Narayan run school, which was not able to send all its hostlers back home. So they are housing 50 students coming from some of the most affluent families from all across Gujarat in one hostel since the lockdown has begun, and we are creating an observation paper of how do they keep them engaged and what all interesting are they doing with them. And they're doing some phenomenal stuff. So we'll be sharing that observation paper in some time. It's right now you're getting prepared. So I would again request everybody who's here to create observation papers on whatever is happening during this lockdown, or whatever new you are experiencing in this whole ecosystem, because this ecosystem is going to drastically change. And we need a new knowledge bank now. We need a new rule book. We're all looking for that. So let's now hear it from PS Kalra, sir. Kalra, sir, over to you. The next 2 minutes are yours. You can unmute your audio.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The normals have already changed for the society. And of course, for the schools. Now, online teaching and offline teaching is not a point of discussion. Every school is doing more than expected. Teachers have learned the skills to teach online. Online assessment is yet to be learned by many. Now the issue is schools post lockdown. We shouldn't forget that schools are not the priority of any government. Or you can say that government will never be in haste to open the schools. Before opening the schools, we as school administrators need to reinforce the trust amongst parents that we shall take utmost care of students. All schools will be facing the biggest challenge, not only in terms of running the classes, but in organizing other essential activities by maintaining the social distance. Mental health of staff and students would be the biggest challenge. The challenge would be further bigger for boarding schools, as they have to see the boarding and lodging too with social distancing. Other challenge would be keeping a strict vigil towards the employees who are coming and going back. Every day you need to follow certain protocols, and we need to have certain such protocols for all operations of the schools, starting from scanning and sanitization of school staff and students. Sanitization of school buses, washrooms, classrooms, dining spaces, and dormitories on daily basis would be required, and maybe more than once in a day. All supplies and materials to be sanitized before coming to the contact with anyone. Masks and disposable gloves to become part of our life. Professional agencies and doctors to be kept on standby mode to meet any kind of eventuality. We need to identify a space in which we can quarantine the suspects if need be. The financial losses are bound to be there in the process of maintaining all these. One carelessness or mistake at the end of anyone can ruin all your planning and effort. Thank you.
Thank you, Kalra sir, for giving us a very good, nicely imagined landscape of the school that's going to come. Thank you so much for sharing that. What we can feel after talking to so many people right now, that as a model, or the way we understood a school, by the definition of it, will have to be altered, not just from the financial perspective of it, but from all the perspectives of it. Because there were some assumptions in running a school, and those assumptions don't exist anymore. So let's find the new assumptions now. Let's now hear it from Dinesh, ma'am. Ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen out there. Thank you so much, Balbor, for this wonderful platform and this wonderful time to spend and share our views with wonderful people out here. Thank you so much. Basically, being a principal of a school which has been started recently, which is situated in the rural parts of Bangalore, okay? Completely, it is a big disaster, I must say. COVID-19 pandemic is a big disaster for the entire world. But when it comes to education, because education was already in a disaster state, okay? I must say this, I don't know how many of you accept it or not, because everyone tries that, everyone tries to prove that, or everyone is under assumption, as Daksh sir was telling, we are giving a better education for our kids. But I don't know how much or how far that quality education exists. Being the educators or being the persons who are having an important role or who are playing a very important responsibilities to impart education with the main stakeholders, parents, teachers, and the students, we are the bridge here to maintain the gaps or to bridge that gap. Okay, coming to that, post lockdown, COVID-19 school, completely a big challenge for the education sector, because ultimately everything starts from education and ends with education. Ultimately, any human being, when he is a culprit or when he is a important celebrity or when he is a responsible person of the nation, including PM, everyone says that what is a educated, what kind of education he has got. When he's a culprit also, we will only point out what kind of education he has got, either his civilization or his education. When it comes to that, being educators like all of us, completely it's a big question, how will we manage it? Okay, and it is completely, I agree with Daksh sir, that we are under assumption that we would manage the things well. Definitely not. Okay, institutions is not that easy to manage, because institution setup, education, and the quality education, all institutional setup, finance, and education. These are all the three core aspects where we have to point out. When it comes to institutional setup, ultimately, we will take more time to manage the things, as we have started online courses also, but still we don't know how far we can educate them. And second thing, finance. Everyone is under distress to manage or to balance between finance. Quality education is none other than the last or the priority aspect for all of us. If we could reach with balancing all this, we will be under a good status of the place where we can prove ourselves that being an educator, I am doing something for my kids. Okay, completely, I'm satisfied with whatever I am. Maybe I'm able to, give that impact, okay, of that education, what the parents are looking for. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. We would again request, within your 2 or 3 minutes, please try to share at least one small idea that others can learn from you. Even a small little innovation that you think that's worth sharing, because even small innovations can help people a lot. Because what we found out during these lockdowns, once we started doing that sharing of ideas, we actually had a lot of circulars coming in from a lot of schools that the idea that we heard yesterday, now we are implementing in our school. Okay. So a small idea would actually change a lot of things for a lot of people. So.
Okay, now we are in a stage that we have to accept the situation. We have to adapt whatever we have been strategized for what we have to do. And at the end, we have to execute our action plans. Okay, as we are, into the online teachings and all, I don't believe that online is not at all a waste of time. Completely not. When it comes to the education, what is happening at the lockdown session for the kids at the home, maybe we can speak about life skills. At the end, even mother will say, okay, now time is done. When will he or she goes to school back? Okay, so we have started with online classes. And as I have told, we can, follow the idea of accept, adapt, or act.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, ma'am. Let's now hear it from Sapna, ma'am. Ma'am, over to you.
For
the next minutes, you can unmute your audio. Try to share with us your introduction and one innovation that others can learn from you. Over to you.
Yes. Good evening, Dakshi and Sahilji and the rest of the members over here. In fact, I prefer saying Jai Hind to everybody. That is how I use this salutation. And well, it's very interesting to be here with Blub. I think it is through LinkedIn we got to know each other, Dakshi. So that is and why I was so restless all throughout. What happened just before 5 p.m. We had a huge dust storm here in Rajasthan. I am from Kota, Rajasthan, and head to different organizations. One is my own, and the other one is a group of schools where I am working as director academics and administration, and the other one is Edge Academy, that is ours. And so what happened, the laptop, everything. So I was just trying to fix my mobile and was just trying to be a little comfortable, but whatever. There can be glitches with technology, but then yes, it helps. Now, straight away, I'll come to my idea. See, I have been advocating before Corona, and probably I'll keep advocating after Corona also. What is one essential thing, not only for schools, but the entire academia? Because it is there where we are creating future of the nation, or maybe future for I mean, they can even become global leaders. Why not? Who stops? In fact, people from Indian origin, they are doing fantastically well across the country, world. So one thing which I have been advocating, and I would like to, like, through your platform, and that's actually one more thing. When you say observation papers, I have been writing almost quite regularly and maintaining a record of all these things. So my very simple thing is, let's have introduction of a formal military education to the entire learning fraternity. When it is military education, I do not mean to say formally we introduce NCC or NSS or something and you say that we've done a couple of life skill activities and that's it, or we've done an adventure training with the children and that's it, or we just took out children, or we outsourced an adventure course to some organization and that's the end of it. When I say military introduction of military education to schools, I talk about everything. Why I say this, I have a background. My husband, Colonel Piyush Agarwal, he is a Kargil war veteran, and he was his entire team, they were the first group of people who were from the Dras sector, they were sent ahead. So we are very happy that he could come back alive and he's still with us, and he talks a lot about all these things. And how it happens, what military education does is, it first of all teaches every single individual to start learning how to live in minimum as well as in maximum. Another thing which is very important with military education is that they allow everybody, people from the entire country can come together and they stay there's a lot of camaraderie which comes to. They know that, you know, survival of the fittest. How they have to survive in tough times. And I'm not talking only about financial status, I'm also talking about the mental status, survival of the fittest. So when we start doing it, let's start building up a curriculum. In fact, I've been doing it for a couple of years and I've been experimenting in our organizations and we are very happy with that, with the outcomes. For last almost 7 to 8 years in Edge Academy, we've been implementing. We get a group of students who come to prepare for various competitions with us. One of them is NDA. And we put them in a military-like situation over here. And we take only a handful. We are not open to many. We take only a handful. And so what we see is the outcomes are fantastic. They've been able to survive in best of the things, and they've been able to survive. So they've learned sort of, I know one hand is up. I just go with right. So they've sort of learned, yes, they can. And the best thing is, they understand what is being an Indian. They understand nationality. They start respecting people. So let's start building a curriculum. Sahilji, can we do it together? I mean, we can definitely exchange our contacts or numbers. Dakshi, you'll have to do it. And I am completely there, right from pre-nursery playgroup that, and up to class 12 and then for higher education. Let's build a curriculum which is military-like education. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you so much,
Saptara. Jai Hind once again. Yeah.
Thank you, Jai Hind. Teaching minimalism, formal military education, camaraderie, surviving in tough times, and again a sense of nationality. This is something that should become a part of life skills, because this is a very good way and a very tabulated way to teach life to everybody. Thank you so much. And let's now hear it from Dr. Sanjay. Dr. Sanjay, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio. Before I go to the next speaker, I forgot one thing which I say in the initiation of the talk. The language is not a challenge. English, Hindi, dono mein se aap jo istemal karna chahe wo kare. Bhasha kabhi bhi gyan ka paimana nahi hoti. It's never the barometer of knowing whether you know it or not. So bhasha aap jo istemal karna chahe kare, the idea is very, very important. So over to Dr. Sanjay.
Sir, thank you very much for inviting me to this session. But briefly speaking, now I'm proud to be a part of KIT and KISS. We have 70,000 kids, and KIT is internationally famous university. KISS is famous for its tribal school. Now, here we could visualize the effect of this pandemic crisis by December, January. So we had already planned, second of these leaders have to understand when there is a world pandemic which is starting from India and it might go anywhere. So that is what our founder is always advanced and we always are guided by him. So that way we already had thought of it. So we did not face any major challenges. By February, every exam was over, and by March 15, the new session had to start. And then only this lockdown came in. And then we had thought of this, as ma'am has told also, Mr. Kalra also has kind of described what are the challenges which boarding schools and day boarding schools will face separately. But this is a school which has day boarding and boarding along with two international boards, ICSE, IB, and also CBSE. So, but anyhow, we are able to kind of handle the children and the parents. Now, we will talk about here post-COVID crisis. How is it? So, at least we have got some ideas. Though government has decided to open 15th June, they have told. But I'm very sure all the leaders should try to understand, as long as India is not out of this, anywhere one single case, you can't open it. Because here it's a multicultural school where children come from different parts of the country and also abroad. So we have planned in our mind October after Dasara. Okay. But anyhow, if at all we are opening, looking at the other schools, we have the plans to run two shifts. We have thought of shifts like this, nearby and little far away children. So we have two shifts. Secondly, or because you can't allow them to play here in a group, that's not possible. Only it will be academic and some life skill programs. And in-house, kind of internally, whatever you can do, some sports, that will be done. But another day also we have learned from Delhi or even formula, that is also in our mind. So two shifts it will run as per the kind of situation. But I think it will be more viable if we do earlier ones, like in the distant places, those who are coming, there will be first shift and the nearby will be the second shift. That is possible. That is one way we are looking at it. And regarding, as ma'am told, that yes, military kind of training, etc., we have always life skill training. We have a lot of CAS programs involved in KISS, which is kind of appreciated all over the world. But military kind, I'm a little object because it's a world pandemic. It's not that only by doing nationalities or nationalism will survive. It is a kind of world pandemic which is everywhere. So that way, I will always emphasize on immunity. We have a health nutrition. We have a Vedic memory lab where, though it's an international school, you also give some philosophy from Vedic science. And that's really very important. And our own nutrition, etc., that is being gathered by them. So though we have heard a lot of things like children, those who come from outside, etc., they like a lot of non-veg. It's not like that. The way we develop them here, they will follow that same track. So definitely, if we as a school take some little care about how to develop immunity through yoga, through the Vedic method, even through some food habits, it's amazing. But as others have told, online teaching, etc., everybody has now learned. So that's not a new thing. I will use this online now in another way. My all the children, those who are not doing well, they are going through outside tuitions. Even though you pressurize not to send them after 5 o'clock, they go home, definitely they are going somewhere. I will now tell those parents not to spend money. My teachers will be taking evening classes through Zoom or through Google, kind of. We can always use that. So that is what I have learned from this. And another thing I request all the famous educators here, let us not bring any kind of fear or not kind of amongst the children here. Every whenever there is some negativity, there is always a positivity. Now, positivity is that, as you told, concept of school, that only there will be infrastructure, the people will be coming, only school will happen. Not like that. We can have mixed. But yes, I know only online teaching throughout the year will not be viable because of the emotional counseling, psychological, because children want to see. Now we are taking Google, we have taken Team, we have also taken Microsoft, we have also taken Zoom. Different places, different. Even we are doing also Skype. Why we have taken multiple backgrounds? Because the children can see each other. When there is a small language group, they can see each other, they can talk to each other. So we can always use these platforms. Thank you all. Have a nice day. I'll also. Thank you.
Thank you, Sanjay sir. I think you added a new perspective to it. This converting a shift to a school to two shifts is something that a lot of people are doing, but to convert those shifts on the basis of the distance from the school is something, again, interesting that can be done, because for the nearby kids, it's easier to get up in the morning and come to school, and for the far away ones, it will be better.
See, we have our own hospital. We have a COVID hospital where we have patients here. So kids has a big branch. So we have our own facility.
Absolutely. And I think the schools can now become, there are a lot of COVID hotspots. The schools in the coming times can actually become the immunity hotspots. You can start preparing for that, because a school can actually build that confidence again in the society. And a child is the best mode of carrying a communication in society when it's about sensitivity. You can sensitize parents very easily through a child. And yes, I think the school will now become the hotspot for the society's sensibility.
Yes.
Now the role will actually change and it will become great. So thank you so much, Sanjay ji. Let's now hear it from Rajini, ma'am. Ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
I'm Mrs. Rajini Mitra, principal of Dhun Public School, Gwalior. I'm here to throw some light on the working of schools post-lockdown. I believe as the world of education is changing, so we need to bring in new technologies to the education system. After the lockdown, the regular classes won't be the same anymore, as we need to take strict precautions to avoid any kind of uncertainty. Before opening the school, teachers and management should be made aware of the safety rules. It will start from team briefing, launching of the daily checklist, and 100% with the equipments of protection, hand sanitizers in every 2 periods. Detailed cleaning is performed by housekeeping team. Making on the floor to ensure social distancing, 6 feet distance between the students, visitors, staff to be followed. After opening, housekeeping and security should be in clean uniform with mask, gloves for every shift. Mask and hand sanitizers should be made compulsory for everyone in the school. A reminder from teachers to the students of the risk of infection. We will take body temperature before entering the bus and at the end of the day. Social distancing for the teachers and students at least 6 feet of distance. When the students enter the classroom, it's good to have only one student on a single bench, maximum 20 students in one classroom. We should not conduct the morning assembly in the common assembly area. And what we can do is that we organize the morning assembly within the classrooms. Lunch break should be scheduled at different times for different students should be counseled to maintain distance at least 6 feet even in the lunch break. And moreover, students should not share their lunch. Schools should arrange sanitizers for the students and teachers in each and every classrooms and corridors. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Dakshji, are you convinced with my things? You want me to review again? Anything else?
Actually, we'll come back to you, ma'am, in the second round. Let's first hear it from Sanjay ji.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Let's now hear it from Sanjay Kumar Malik ji. Sanjay ji, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio. Try to share with us an idea or an innovation that you think that will help schools in the best possible way.
Yeah. Thank you very much, everyone. I'm Sanjay Kumar Malik, Principal Sant Nandlal Smriti Vidya Mandir, Ghatshila. Ghatshila is a very small town. And to your utter surprise, I must say, lockdown started, we closed the school on 19th March. And thereafter, the first lockdown, second lockdown. And from 26th March, we started forming the WhatsApp group and start sending the some work to the students. And by first week, we started forming the online classes. And we till now conducting online classes. We conducted PTM, we conducted exams. Now, what I'm trying to explain here is, being a small town, out of 1,300 students, I found only 10 to 15 or max 20 who faced network problem, who faced device problem, who said, I'm not interested, right? Rest all, even the parents were excited. Here I used to tell you that when I was conducting PTM, I said that I cannot leave your children or my student alone. So let them be engaged. So from 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock, we are having scheduled timetable for the classes. We are having Zoom classes where what ma'am was saying, it only can the live skill. No. It's the academic subject we are teaching them. We have said that these classes are compulsory. We are trying to complete the syllabus. And we are doing it wonderfully. It's the 100% parent satisfaction. Top of that, meeting after 3 weeks, they started asking, sir, what about the fees? We don't have online fees taking mechanism. We say, don't worry. let your child study. When school will reopen, we will take money from you. Keep it safe. The third important thing I wish to tell you, spread positivity. कोरोना रहेगी ऐसा नहीं है, इससे भी बड़े बड़े प्रॉब्लम आए हैं जो चले जाएंगे. हमें एक पॉजिटिव माइंडसेट रखना है. ये स्कूल कभी भी सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग नहीं सिखा सकती है. ये तो वी ब्रिंग देम टुगेदर. वी से दैट ऑल कल्चर ऑल रिलीजियस आर टुगेदर, लेट अस ईट टुगेदर, लेट अस प्ले टुगेदर. इफ आई प्रैक्टिस सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग इन माई स्कूल, देन द वेरी पर्पस ऑफ स्कूल इज डिफीटेड. सो द वरी पार्ट ऑफ ऑल प्रिंसिपल आई वुड से कि जब टेम्परेचर 40 डिग्री होती है तो डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन आके कहते हैं स्कूल बंद करो. अगर कोरोना के लिए सेफ नहीं है तो स्कूल ऐसे ही नहीं खुलेंगे. हम फोर्सफुली नहीं खोल सकते, डोर बढ़ा सकते, वो एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन आई जाएगी प्ले में. सो हैव अ ओपन हार्ट, हैव अ स्ट्रॉन्ग बिलीव दैट इट्स ओके, इट टू विल बी ओवर. एंड टॉप ऑफ दैट आई सेड माय टीचर्स दैट दिस इज नॉट द फैंसी थॉट वी आर प्रैक्टिसिंग. We have learned the technology, now it will carry on throughout our school period. Mean to say, I said, the 20 marks ka question jo hum half yearly mein poochte hain, ye bhi hum online lenge. Aap abhi device se kar rahe hain, theek hai. Bank of India, I heard that they are giving some personal loans. Okay, I said we will purchase laptop for every teacher, right? And this will not stop. Now it is not that life will not change. School will remain school, teacher will remain teacher. But the basic essence of education will prevail. और उसके लिए हमें मानसिक रूप से तैयार होने पड़ेंगे. Principals यहाँ पर बहुत lead role लेते हैं. Thank you very much. I hope I could say my what I'm doing here. And but every school positivity spread करे, डरे नहीं. ये मैं Ministry of Home Affairs का dialogue नहीं बोल रहा हूँ. डरे नहीं, ये कोरोना भी चली जाएगी. Okay, let us enjoy this period. Whatever comes up, we will do better in that. Thank you very much. Thank you, Balwold. Thank you, Daksh. And thank you, everyone in the panel.
Thank you so much, Sanjay. I think you shared a very nice idea that schools cannot actually teach social distancing because they are meant to teach the society coming together. Thank you so much for sharing that perspective with us. So thank you so much, everybody, for sharing your thoughts. Before we conclude the talk, let's have a concluding remark from Sahilji. Sahilji, over to you for the next 1 minute for a concluding remark. Okay.
I thought the leaders have already, you know, given so many great suggestions. But I generally thank everyone. These were very brilliant ideas, and they show the experience they're coming from. So because I'm not actively in the school educational domain, so we sometimes miss this input, and it's great to hear that from you. Based on what Sapnaji and Sanjayji were sharing, I think we should reflect on what is the purpose of education. And I think all of us agree, and we have heard this many times, that it's, you know, discovering our full potential, you know, becoming full as a human being. And in the corona world, we have realized this, ki hum bahar hum kuch bhi achieve karne, that means nothing. You know, the real victory is inside. Wo humko ban ki shakti dena, ban vijay kare. So that's the real thing that, you know, we all aspire for. And to do that, I think it's absolutely necessary that we build their foundation during the education times. Build a spiritual foundation in our kids during their school time, during their college time. So in our educational institutions, you know, we've started doing that. And I think the first step towards that is that as educators, as teachers and principals, we have to get into that very proactively and very honestly and genuinely. For the last around 10 years, I have been into meditation and spirituality, and the kind of wonders that it has done when we work in the education sector, it's amazing. And I would request all of you to consider that very actively, especially it's on during this online period, lockdown period. A lot can be achieved in the spiritual world.
Thank you so much, Sahilji. So before we conclude this talk, I just want to add two or three thoughts to you so that there's some more food for thought, so that when we meet next, I can have some more better ideas coming in from you. So at the moment, what all we can feel ki India ka ek bahut acha mythological example hai ki samudra manthan hua tha, vish aur amrit dono nikle the, to ab ye shiksha ka manthan ho raha hai. So ab usme dono nikalna hai. So at this point, I think the core responsibility of anybody who can observe well and can document his observations, this is the right time to create that knowledge. आप अपने आसपास जो कुछ देख रहे हैं शिक्षा में जो बदलाव, because education just does not end with an infra coming in place. एक आपने टेक दे दिया उससे काम, बिकॉज अभी इतने दिनों तक इतने लोगों से बात करने के बाद व्हाट यू टू अंडरस्टैंड इज कि मोस्ट ऑफ दीज एड टेक कंपनीज और द एड टेक प्लेटफॉर्म्स दैट यू आर यूजिंग, दे आर नॉट सॉल्विंग एजुकेशन प्रॉब्लम्स, दे आर सॉल्विंग कम्युनिकेशन प्रॉब्लम्स. आपको शिक्षा के लिए नए समाधान ढूंढ रहे हैं, बिकॉज शिक्षा का इनेबलमेंट अब मुश्किल होगा. मुश्किल इसलिए होगा क्योंकि बहुत सारा डर उसके साथ में जुड़ गया है. उस डर को हटाने के लिए भी शिक्षा ही काम करेगी, बट वो होगा कैसे और वो सीमलेसली कैसे हो. इंडिया में शिक्षा के साथ एक बहुत बड़ा प्रॉब्लम यह है कि पॉलिसी शिक्षा को बांध देती है. बट अभी आज साहिल जी को बुलाने का एक बहुत अच्छा बहुत मेजर कारण यह भी था कि he has some experience in policy making as well. So, मेरा एक ये कहना रहेगा सभी से कि आप जो भी पॉलिसी चेंज चाहते हैं उसको डॉक्यूमेंट कीजिए, उसके लिए पीछे उसके कारण दीजिए. बिकॉज अब जो पॉलिसी होगी विद द कमिंग वर्ल्ड वो बहुत ज्यादा कनेक्टेड होगी सभी से. सो जब आपको मौका है पॉलिसी में चेंज लाने का तो उसकी कोशिश तो करिए, होगी कैसे हो तो गॉड नोस. सो आई थिंक कीप शेयरिंग योर आइडियाज, कीप डॉक्यूमेंटिंग देम. Whatever new you see around you, try to share it with us. We are sharing the best innovations with everybody. एक छोटा सा कॉम्पिटिशन हम लोग कर रहे हैं और वो कॉम्पिटिशन फॉर द सेक ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन नहीं है, वो केवल इसलिए है ताकि हम कोई भी छोटी से छोटी इनोवेशन भी ढूंढ के बाहर निकाल पाए. We are trying to find the most creative school in India. अगर आप, आपका management, आपके parents, student कुछ भी creative कर रहे हैं हमारे साथ share कीजिए. We have kept a cash prize for it. The cash prize is not just to, you know, incentivize. It's basically कि भाई कोई किसी का जो कारण बन जाए बस उस कारण से innovation बाहर आ जाए. Because वो छोटा सा idea एक बहुत बड़ा change बन सकता है in the coming times. So our team will stay connected with you. अगर आप कुछ नहीं बोल पाए, कुछ ऐसा रह गया जो आप अब बोलना चाहते हैं, शायद संजय जी भी बोलना चाह रहे थे, तो आप उसे हमें रिटर्न में भेज सकते हैं. इट्स एक्चुअली द टाइम्स ओवर और हम किसी का भी शेड्यूल नहीं बिगाड़ना चाहते. एंड आई होप यू एंजॉयड दिस सेशन. इफ यू एंजॉयड एंड इफ यू वांट टू अटेंड फ्यूचर सेशंस, यू कैन अनम्यूट योर ऑडियो एंड से अ बिग यस.
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू. थैंक यू दर्शी. थैंक यू ब्लॉग. थैंक्स एवरीवन. थैंक यू.